Let's bring the meeting to order.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have some meeting minutes to approve. They would be from our May 8th regularly scheduled council meeting. If there's any additions or corrections, we have a motion to have those approved.
I make a motion to approve those.
Motion on the floor by Mike.
I'll second it.
Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously. Agenda this evening?
I have the renewal of the building permits. Do we want to talk about the hay at the property adjacent to the golf course?
What else would you have to go?
That was all that I had.
Taking the building permits off?
Yep.
Oh, they wanted to take the permits off.
There's no permits in it.
Nope. And then that's about the hay.
Yep, we'll move that human thing down to the bottom. Any other additions or corrections? If not, I need to have a motion of the agenda approved.
I make that motion.
Motion on the floor by Steph.
I'll second.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously. First item we have on the agenda is fire department applicant, Chief Bolzer.
So bring them both up.
Yep, come on up, Chris.
Bring your own chair though.
Yeah.
Ron, thank you, buddy.
BYOC.
Well, as you know, a few folks, back in May, we posted for the application process to begin for both the chief's position and the captain's position. The captain's position, after closing, had one applicant, and that was John Dushner, who decided to run for it. The current one, Jason Bolzer, decided at this time that he was had a little bit too much going on, and for those reasons, he decided to not reapply. John will make an excellent captain. Look forward to working for him. So he'll be, I don't know if you guys need to approve them individually.
Yeah, I believe we should. So Brian, recommendation then from the...
Recommendation from us is that to put in state John as the captain.
Let's first recognize and get a motion to approve Jason Bolzer's resignation as captain.
Not really a resignation. I'd make a motion to thank Jason for his years of service, dedicated service as a captain.
Absolutely.
He did an excellent job also.
Absolutely. Let's get a motion to have that approved.
I'll make that motion.
Motion on the floor by Mike.
I'll second the motion.
Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously. Brian.
And just let it be known that this will actually take place on the first Thursday of the month of July.
It's one of their new positions.
Okay. Correct.
On the first of July. And let's get a motion to approve.
Oh, I was gonna say, and I'll make the motion that we instate John Dushner as captain.
Very good stuff. Can we get a second?
I'll second.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously.
And the second position was for the chief's position. And we had two applicants, Chris Young and Phil Scribner, both applied, put their name in, which it's fabulous to have some people showing interest in these positions. So we went through the application process with both representatives from the city and the townships, along with fire department personnel. And we recommend that Chris Young will also take over the first Thursday of July as the new fire chief.
Well, problem I have is we can't have two fire chiefs, so we're gonna have to accept your resignation.
You bet. I make the motion.
This isn't really a resignation. Brian has served his terms. There are term limits. Brian actually served just about four terms.
Yes, three and a half, 11 and a half years.
So Brian Ryan's term as fire chief is up. Sorry to see you leave, Ryan.
Well, thank you.
Done a hell of a job for us, so I really appreciate everything you've done, been able to accomplish, and don't think that you're leaving without a lot of appreciation, so.
Still here to take part. I look forward to working for the new leadership. I'll aid in any way that I can in the future and look forward to working for these individuals.
Thanks, Brian. We will need a motion to have that accepted.
We have a motion to accept Brian's term limits being done.
Motion on the floor by Mike.
I'll second.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. Next.
Go ahead.
No.
I'll make a motion that we instate Chris Young as the new fire chief.
There is a motion on the floor.
Second that.
By Stephanie and second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. I would just like to add, I've had the opportunity to work with Chris for a lot of years. I tell you, we're in good hands. The city and the townships are in very good hands with Chris at the helm. Great leadership.
Well, he was second in command already, so he learned under Brian. They learned, and they do well.
But Chris is an individual that I have all the confidence in the world with and for. And anything you need, Chris, you be sure to let us know. Whatever we can do to help make this transition easier, or if there's anything you see in the future that you might need, be sure you we'll be in touch anyway. So.
You bet. Yep.
Be sure you let us know.
Yeah, the department's in great shape. Taking over a great organization. So
I know you'll
do us the opportunity.
You'll do us all proud, Chris. Thank you much, you guys.
I've got one more thing I'd like to bring up now that we're up here. I received notification here last Friday that the Pierce Fire Department was awarded that grant that we had applied for last year from FEMA for the amount of $94,000 to purchase new SCBAs, or breathing apparatus that we wear. So we will start the process with that. Bob has looked into doing some of the paperwork today, I believe, with Nicole. So we've got that tracking right now that we've accepted. So now it's just some paperwork that has to be signed and taken care of, and then some bank routing things, and we will be looking at purchasing new equipment.
Excellent.
So that's wonderful news.
Excellent job. Another $94,000 for the city and townships and for our department. Great job, you guys.
So dumb question. Since our assistant chief is now the chief, do you have to post for an assistant chief?
Once Chris takes over here in July, he will post, and he will start that process at that point.
Okay.
We should have a motion for the record to accept the FEMA grant, by the way, as well.
I make a motion that we accept the FEMA grant for the fire department for our new SCBAs.
Total of $94,000. Motion on the floor by Mike.
Or
by
Bob.
Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously.
And that's all I've got. Otherwise, anything else, we've been running good.
Brian, thanks again.
Yeah,
thank you
both of you very much.
Thank you.
Chris, good luck.
Yep.
You bet.
Thank you.
Enjoy it. Welcome.
Thanks, kid.
Been a pleasure.
You too, Brian.
You keep up the good work, Phil.
No.
Next item on the agenda, we have the approval of resolution 0626-2017 records retention schedule. Is this something we normally do every year in call?
No, they updated it. They made some changes and everything, so I thought it would be good to approve it and make sure we follow the record retention that we should be, and so that we're up to date and current with
we'll see a motion to have that approved.
Whereas, to comply with the records management statute, MS 138.17, it is necessary to adapt a plan for managing governmental records, including the proper retention and disposal of municipal records. And whereas, the records management statute, MS 138.17, establishes that records disposition panel and requires all government entities to follow an orderly process disposing of government information. And whereas, the state of Minnesota has approved for use by all Minnesota cities the Minnesota General Records Retention Schedule for Cities, which authorizes cities adapting said schedule and orderly method of disposing of municipal records. And whereas, the Minnesota General Records Retention Schedule for Cities is regularly updated. Now therefore be it resolved by the City Council of the City of Pierce, Minnesota adapts the Minnesota General Records Retention Schedule and directs the City Clerk to notify the Minnesota Historical Society State Archives Department. Be it further resolved that following state approval, city departments are directed to provide for retention and destruction of records as set forth in said schedule and in subsequent revisions adapted by the City Council of the City of Pierce, Washington County on this 26th day of June 2017.
There has been a motion on the floor by Kyle to adopt the resolution. Can we get a second?
I'll second.
Second by Stefan. All those in favor signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Something. Motion unanimous. Nicole, do you want to talk a little bit about...
She's not here. Yeah.
Let's skip over that because she's going to talk about that a little bit. Just as kind of an FYI for everybody, OSHA is going to be doing a walk through City Hall here June 27th. Not sure what time she said. 10:30 here?
10 o'clock, Bill.
10 o'clock. Okay. You'll be here too?
Yes, sir. Background was completed. I handed it over to Nicole early last week, so she put it into a personnel file. His start date is going to be July 24th, the Monday. Per the committee and agreement with Kelvin, we agreed to, so we can help me on this one, $24 an hour.
Yep.
And then on top of that, it's he's 5 years of experience, full-time experience, so it puts him where it's under, but it's he agreed to where he wants to be. And then I think per policy, we're talking to Nicole. He's given 40 hours of vacation up front, and then he'll be placed on a 6-month probationary period per the city policy. But his date, he is done down there July 4th or the 5th. He wants to take some time to come back home, so I'm just working on his schedule. If it happens, it happens. That's what we've got 24th.
We approved this, and to refresh my memory, you guys, we approved this based on his background check.
That's correct.
So that's when the
and the background came back flying colors. It's we're getting a great candidate, but something that's going to put many years into this community, so we're very lucky to get on.
Yeah, so you try to create a great company. I don't know if there's anything else you need to say. You need to
just formally.
Yeah.
I make a motion that we hire Calvin Sheet up to $24 an hour and the insurance and that a starting date is July 24th.
Or thereabouts.
Or thereabouts. Possibly earlier.
Motion on the floor by Mike. Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed. Carried unanimously.
Just during days of vacation.
And then I don't have nothing early for my police report at the end of the
okay.
Next month, so other than that, I don't have you chose to know what concerns are.
Okay, everything's going okay, Chief?
Grand Electronics is putting a station here at City Hall for us with an antenna, so it's going to,
oh,
if there's any in both spots with the Little Falls foothills. It's going to be our pure connection to our next tower of Armenia.
Okay.
Pierce is going to benefit off Spitzkin. It's all off of Marsa County with their new five systems. So it's just we're benefiting here in Pierce at no cost. So we started that early. We started that Thursday or Friday last week. They put a 10 on this year. Those are the substation right in the Pierce.
That's all 800 acres.
So here again, just reference to aging again.
Absolutely. So if something would happen at the county, they go down, they could come out here and dispatch.
Deputies can utilize this one.
Yeah.
Cool. Other than I have nothing, it's all, it's going good, it's busy, no, it's, there's school that it's managed.
Thank you.
The hay. We talked about the hay as well.
Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, hey, hey.
Let's talk about the hey, hey, hey.
Let's talk about the hey, hey, hey.
In regards to some meadow hay on the Heeman's property, I just kind of talked about it a little bit before when we had our workshop. And it would be kind of nice if we could find somebody who would be willing, and I don't know if we will, but somebody who would be willing to maybe go in there with a sycamore and mow the hay down. They could certainly have the hay. Cutting it, I don't think the city has any interest in that. I think it'd be a fair trade. I think based on maybe some damage that they have to their equipment.
That would be kind of my
equipment. You know, I think if you went in there with a sickle mold, you would be able to get a considerable amount of this metal hay out there. So if anybody has any interest, certainly get a hold of us here at City Hall. We'd like to see it cut. So.
Post that in our Adobe, is that?
Sure.
Just
certainly
could. There,
yeah, then that's probably a good book. We could post here and maybe post something in the paper.
Chapter 8. Yeah, chapter 8.
Oh, perfect. Gotcha.
Kyle's suggestion was maybe we could post.
Just advertise it maybe in the
record.
Plug
in a
record.
Who's interested.
Yeah.
But I want to take no liability on the end here.
No
responsibility.
Be some nice stuff, though.
So, are you guys okay with that?
For controlled training.
If that doesn't go, next spring we might have another training session on burning it up.
So put an ad in the record to see if anybody's interested in that.
We're
just doing it on the Facebook page.
Yeah. It's in the middle
on the city website or whatever. Well, Terry will make a notation on there.
Right after
sounds like free advertising.
That's your terminology.
Page ad on that.
Conflict of interest.
Informational.
They only have their own risk. Is that
what you're saying? I don't know if any permit would risk it.
So we skipped over this because.
Can we get a motion just to have that approved, you guys?
I make a motion that we advertise somehow.
On Facebook and the website.
On Facebook and the website that is there. Call the city.
Don't just go get it. Call the city.
Call the city first.
Motion on the floor by Kyle. Can we get a second?
I'll second it.
Second by Mike. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Carried unanimously.
Oh, will we be doing any prices on anything? Or just if anybody wants to come in?
They want them. They can take it.
Okay, perfect.
It's free. We'll go back up on top, towards the top. Nicole, can you tell us a little bit about the Good Life Grant that you received?
Yes. So Carrie applied for a Good Life Grant through, I believe, with NJPA. She went and presented in Staples. There was 20-some people presenting. And we asked for $3,000, and it was for 6 bike racks, 2 picnic tables. The picnic tables would be for the Veterans Memorial. The bike racks would be just around town. We asked for $3,000, and we were rewarded with $3,000 in grants. So between Bob and Carrie, they're going to work together with the racks and get the picnic tables going.
Awesome.
Good. We've been asked for a while, so that's kind of nice when we get that.
Yeah, did a great job. So.
Yeah. So I'll ask for a motion to approve that grant.
Make that motion.
Motion on the floor by Dave.
Second.
second.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. Let's see here. Eric didn't have anything for his report. He said everything is pretty much going good. We'll just kind of skip our way down. I see Bob didn't make it this evening, so Nicole, do you have anything on your end?
Just kind of, we're going to be setting up employee reviews here shortly, get those all taken care of, and to you guys here in the next week or two. We did hear from Scott from SCH about hole number 5 for the golf course. Looks like they've got some things set up and ready to go, so they're working with the DNR and soil and water, so I think he's going to be here, what did he say? Yep, the 24th or before. He might try to set up a meeting with us prior to that. Other than that, I don't really have much going on.
Thanks, Nicole. Mm-hmm. Treasurer's report.
A checkbook balance with a statement on May 31st was $752,365.51.
Do you have any CDs or anything else going on?
We don't have any CDs for like 5 years since we cashed in them on that.
Okay. The rest of them are all out of treasurer's report. We will need a motion to approve the treasurer's report.
I'll make that motion.
Motion on the floor by Steph.
I'll second.
Second by Mike. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. Is there anything else that we forgot or anything that came up at the last minute here we need to deal with?
Do we go over the OSHA walk-through that's tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
just
yeah.
Also,
yeah.
We have to say what's going on. That's good.
If not, we will need a motion to adjourn.
I make that motion.
Motion on the floor by Mike.
Second.
Second by Stephanie. All those in favor, signify by stating aye.
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 Aye. Opposed?